You join me today in ancient Greece. It's
wow, this doesn't look like that good lighting.
Thanks. It's not what you're expecting, but it's 6th century BC. And in particular, we're on a Greek island just off the coast of Turkey. It's called Samos. And I know what you're thinking. You'd like to dig a tunnel through a mountain, wouldn't you? Question is, how on earth do you dig a tunnel through a mountain when you don't have access to any modern equipment? I'll tell you how you dig a tunnel through a mountain. Okay, so here is your mountain. Lovely. Now, there are a couple of things that you need to dig a tunnel through a mountain. You're gonna need to have an entrance and an exit. Those are the two requisite components of a tunnel. So let's say you wanna go in here, and you wanna come out here. Now, the thing is that you can't just start digging in here and just hope that you'll come out here. It's not gonna work, right? You need to make sure that you hit the right bit. So what people tend to do, this is what they did for the Channel Tunnel, for example, is you start digging here and you start digging here and you just hope that they line up. Except that, I mean, you're unlikely to find each other in the middle of a mountain. So you need a technique to make sure that these two lines end up meeting up in the middle. And the way that you do that is by using triangles.
I would have thought if you made absolutely sure you were digging in a straight line, you'd be all right. As long as you look behind you and the hole is still behind you.
Yeah, but the straight line, but hang on, if you were in a straight line, okay, so let's imagine that you, let me do like a contour of this mountain. It's quite a wobbly mountain, this one. So you want to go in here and you want to come out here. The problem is that if you dig in a straight line, you could end up over here.
Right, so how do you make sure
you make sure that you get exactly there? And it's not like you can just stand on the top of the mountain and you go, oh, head in that way, lads. You know what I mean? Because you can't, when you're standing over here, you can't see around there.
Right.
So it's really hard to even know.
I feel like in the era of GPS, you could just do the straight line.
In GPS, I think you probably can. Right. I think you probably can. Apart from the fact that you're in a tunnel, I don't think signal's great in tunnels, but...
But if you start in a straight line and then just keep looking behind you to make sure that the hole's still there, you know you're going in a straight line. Anyway, so you're saying the main problem is you can't see the other side.
You can't see where you're going. Yeah, exactly. So the way that you do this, it's very neat. So you try and walk around from one side of the mountain to the other. And as you go, you want to try and stay at the same level as you go around. Every time you take a step south, you add it up. Every time you take a step to the west, you add it up. And you're very careful about how big all of your steps are as you're going. Maybe you do this twice, just to make sure that you've got the right numbers. You've done it all in units and right angles, and you've been really careful all the way along. Because even in ancient Greece, you can imagine it'd be quite easy to construct a right angle. Wouldn't be too difficult. But in total then, imagine that you have taken 84 steps west and you have taken 13 steps south. So effectively then, to get the direction from one place to the other, you are talking about a triangle with those as the sides. So you know it's gonna be 84 along there and 13 along there. And you know that that's a right angle because you've only ever walked south and west. And so you have this very nice, neat triangle. I deliberately chose one that was a Pythagorean triple. You're welcome. So this is 85. So now actually, when you are at the entrance to each of these tunnels, you can construct a much smaller version of the same triangle and build it here. And if you make a kind of really long rod to sort of extend that angle, and you do the same thing over here, so you've got another version of the triangle here, then you should have these two lines, these two angles that will meet really perfectly in the middle. Boom. So the only thing you've got to be careful of now is when you're digging, to make sure that you stay perfectly flat. You don't want to go up, you don't want to go down. And the way that they do that is that they put water in the tunnel. And then as they're digging, they make sure that the water just sits nice and still rather than dripping in one direction or the other.
Like a spirit level.
Like a spirit level, exactly. This particular mountain, this is Samos, and this was in 525 BC. Polycrates, I don't think it's called Polycrates. How do you pronounce polycrates?
Polycrates.
Oh, it's Polycrates. Whatever. Polycrates, he wanted a tunnel.
Polycrates.
you can shush. Polycrates, he wanted this tunnel. It's a kilometre long, 525 BC this was built, and this is exactly the technique that archaeologists think that they used. And when they did so, they did incredibly well. There was a tiny bit of zigzagging at one end, and they think it was because they were trying to work their way around some quite difficult rock, but then they re-established this sort of plumb line, as it were. And when these two tunnels met in the middle, there's like a tiny little step of 60 centimetres. It's like this unbelievably remarkable achievement with just some triangles.
How do you know where to put those triangles so the triangles are at the right?
That's got to be a line that runs exactly east to west, and that's got to be a line that runs exactly north to south. Do they have compasses?
Yeah.
I'm assuming they had compasses.
Well, they knew. They had the sun.
They had the sun.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. You're open and closed to the tunnel. They actually need to be at the same level before you start. You know,
the same altitude.
Yeah, the same altitude, exactly. Your water thing wouldn't work if you had one of your... If you were like, yeah, let's start there. And you hadn't worked out that actually one was much more uphill than the other. Now, this is something they're not quite sure about how they did it, how they managed it. But there is some suggestion. I'm not convinced by this. But there's some suggestion. Some archaeologists think that created this tower and then got a massive long stick. maybe I haven't understood this quite right, but my understanding of it is they went up to the top of a tower and then they dangled a big long stick down and then they sort of swung it around the mountain. So they were like, oh, there you go. That's a nice point right there.
Well, you could use a rope for that, surely.
And make it straight. Yeah.
Like taut. Although it's pretty hard to keep a rope that long taut.
Yeah, it's like a kilometre. But I don't think they built a kilometre long stick either.
No.
Anyway, some mysteries remain unsolved, shall we say.
This episode was supported by Brilliant, loving creators of puzzles and courses like these. Brilliant's all about interaction, getting you to move things around, click and think, slide things into place. That's the key to understanding, really engaging with what you're learning. Check out their huge and ever-growing library of material at brilliant.org/numberphile. Using that /numberphile will bag you a 20% discount on their premium subscription, by the way. And if you're looking for that something special for the learner in your life, you can also give a Brilliant subscription as a gift. Check them out, brilliant.org/numberphile.
There's a certain type of lizards that use... the way that the males dominate one another follows a rock, paper, scissors type game. There's the orange lizards. These are the guys, they're called ultra dominant, right? They've got big territories, they've got loads of females. They're the big guys, right?